Good morning, one and all. Respected judges, I am Praharsha and this is Maitreyi, with third year MBBS students from Kakatiya Medical College, Warangal. My title is Effects of GUTKA Chewing on Vision. Before directly going into the research part, I would like to give a brief intro about the topic. As we all know, chewing tobacco has been a tradition in India for many centuries. The prevalence of smokeless tobacco is growing rapidly among children and adolescents. Smokeless tobacco includes GUTKA, which attributes to 8% of total smokeless tobacco consumption in India, according to Global Adult Tobacco Survey. GUTKA, also known as pan masala containing tobacco, is one of the most commonly used tobacco products in India. GUTKA, along with tobacco, contains a mixture of areca nut, slaked lime, catechu, and a number of spices. Many consumers believe that this blend is not harmful, but it's more harmful than other forms due to an increased risk of systemic absorption. Smoking is reported to be an increased risk factor for eye diseases such as cataract, glaucoma, age-related macular degeneration, and toxic optic neuropathy. Similar findings can be seen in GUTKA chewers too, but only few studies have shown that tobacco chewing is strongly associated with vision impairment. The majority of research attention on GUTKA has focused on cancer from an epidemiological standpoint. However, its effect on vision have not been well characterized. This study attempts to evaluate the various adverse effects caused by GUTKA chewing on vision. The aims and objectives of my study were to study the effects of GUTKA on vision, to observe which parts of the eye are affected, and to determine which part of the eye is affected more. Coming to materials and methods, study design and setting. A cross-sectional study was conducted on 58 patients visiting Regional Eye Hospital, Warangal, Telangana, and the Department of Ophthalmology, Kakatiya Medical College, Warangal. Inclusion criteria. Patients belonging to an age group of 15 to 55 years and consume GUTKA were included. Details on duration and quantity of GUTKA usage were ascertained. Exclusion criteria. Patients who were alcoholics or smokers or both were excluded from the study. Patients with congenital vision defects were excluded. Patients with diabetes mellitus were excluded. Procedure. Complete ocular examination of the patients was performed with consent of the patient. Testing for visual acuity was done. Using slit lamp examination, conjunctival examination, cornea, pupillary reactions, color and transparency of lens was seen for. Intraocular pressure was measured using tonometry. Fundus examination was done by ophthalmoscopy and slit lamp. The data gathered was entered into MS Excel sheet and was analyzed using SPSS software. P-values less than 0.05 were considered significant. Implications for the study. There are studies done which prove that chewing tobacco has definitive effect on vision impairment, mainly toxic optic neuropathy, but there's no sufficient data on which part of the eye is affected more. At the end of this study, we shall be able to identify the extent of damage caused to various parts of the eye due to GUTKA chewing. Results. As we can see from the table, this study, according to the distribution of subjects, according to this study, majority of them, that is 89.7%, were males. Distribution of subjects according to their age. As we can see, majority of them belong to the age group 45 to 54 years, that is 50% of them. Distribution of subjects according to their occupation. Majority, that is 84.5%, were employed. 8.6% were unemployed, and 6.9% were students. Distribution of subjects according to place of living. Majority, that is 63.7%, belong to urban background. This table shows the effect of GUTKA directly or indirectly on vision and parts of the eye, taking into consideration other comorbidities which were not penned in this study. It was observed that visual acuity was affected with a high significant value. P-value was reported to be less than 0.001. All the parts of the eye were affected except cornea, iris, and pupil. The eyelids and anterior chamber showed a p-value of significance of p-value 0.04, whereas lens, retina, that is optic disc and macula, are the most affected parts of the eye with a high significance. There was also clinical significance. Mainly cataract, toxic optic neuropathy, and macular degeneration were observed. Whereas there was no significance with respect to conjunctiva, intraocular pressure, and vitreous humor. Conclusion. This study shows that GUTKA directly or indirectly has a significant effect on quality of deterioration of vision. Hence, healthcare professionals, that is eye care professionals, should include information on consumption of GUTKA among patients with ocular problems and also in management. Awareness should be created about various adverse effects caused to the eye due to GUTKA. These were my references. Last but not the least, I would like to thank my guide, Dr. G.R. Bharatkumar sir, Associate Professor, Department of Ophthalmology, for extending a tremendous support, and this proposal was accepted for ICMR. Thank you. Excuse me, ma'am.
You said the association with visual acuity fall was significant.
Yes, ma'am.
So how did you measure it?
Using for near vision, we use Snellen's chart and
Landolstat for Favision.
So the initial visual acuity of the patient was recorded?
No, ma'am.
Then how do you know that this fall is because of Gutka chewing?
Like actually we have examined the patients coming to OP department. So we could, at that time we could note down only the visual acuity at that present.
I mean, we tested the other factors also, ma'am. But we've seen that visual acuity was affected more.
No, then how did you see that it's only because of Gutka chewing? You saw the patient only once?
Actually, we have taken their previous records, ma'am, like visual acuity was normal then. And
in their OP slip, it will be, we've asked them about the number of visits, ma'am, to the hospital. And for few patients, we've done follow-up. And for them, in the OP slip, it was written, ma'am, for few patients. The previous visual acuity.
Vision was normal before when they attended the clinic before. And
so you have ruled out other causes of vision fall? All other causes during that period, like any early cataract formation or any other pathology involving the disc or macula?
Yes, ma'am. We have excluded all to establish the perfect association.
Okay. And was there any linear correlation between the history of like time duration of Gutka chewing and the amount of vision fall? Was there any linear correlation between the two?
In pseudophagic patients, there was, as we observed, there were many pseudophagic patients who were asked to stop chewing Gutka, but they didn't. And they reported like there was no vision improvement even after surgery and all.
Now, what I'm asking is, like somebody who's chewing Gutka for 8 to 10 years somebody who's chewing only for 1 year, so was there any difference?
Ma'am. We included that, ma'am, but that is not projected over here.
The duration and quantity we asked for each and every person we considered under study, ma'am. Like significance was more in people who chewed Gutka for more than 5 years than people with less than 5 years. And quantity of Gutka also, there was a correlation, ma'am. There was a significant.
Quantity means how much, like did you assess the quantity?
We tried to grade it, ma'am, but the consumption of Gutka was very regular. Few patients told that when they worried or during festivals, they chew up to 10 Gutkas per day. And on normal days, they chew 4 to 5 Gutkas. So it was not possible to grade exactly. We couldn't regularize the grading. So we included the duration, ma'am.
Okay, and optic nerve and macula were the most affected, you said?
Yes, ma'am.
So what were the changes you saw in optic nerve?
There was paler and there was cupping of optic disc.
Optic disc paler was very prominent.
Cupping was significant?
Yes, ma'am, it was.
So, did you rule out glaucoma in those cases? See, pallor of disc is one thing, cupping is one thing.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, pallor can occur due to toxic optic neuropathy or nutritional optic neuropathies, that is non and torn. Okay. So, Gutka chewing usually causes pallor. Cupping, if it's more, then you should rule out glaucoma in such cases first.
Cupping were very few.
Ma'am, but in our study, there was no significance to intraocular pressure, ma'am. There were only 2 glaucoma patients.
So see, intraocular pressure itself is not whole and sole glaucoma, no. What is the definition of glaucoma? It's intraocular pressure is only one of the causative factors. You will see 35 to 40% of the cases of glaucoma having normal intraocular pressure. Their pressures will be 14 or 15. They will have significant cupping. So that's called low tension glaucoma, normal tension glaucoma. There's a big segment of that people. It's not that always intraocular pressure will be high. So it's very difficult to differentiate. There are a lot of causes you need to rule out in those cases where you have normal intraocular pressure with a pale disc or cupping of the disc. So you can't rule out glaucoma just on the basis of intraocular pressure in such cases. There are a lot of things, other investigations you need to do. Sleep apnea testing you need to do. You need to do the, it's basically an autoregulatory problem. You need to rule out hypertension in that patient. What time antihypertensive patient is using. You need to rule out carotid vascular disease, carotid ocular carotid disease you need to rule out. You need to get the lipid profile done. You need to get cardiac evaluation done. So all those things contribute to your normal tension glaucoma. Okay. So only intraocular pressure would not help you. Intraocular pressure, what method you used for measuring?
Tonometry.
Which one?
NCT.
NCT.
Yes.
NCT is not reliable. You should do Goldman applanation tonometer. That's the most reliable. if you are doing any studies, better you go for Goldman Appellation Tonometer. NCT is not recognized as a standard anywhere in the world.
Okay.
Not even Shiots. So go for Goldman Appellation Tonometer whenever you are going for some paper presentation. Okay?
So you have seen so many samples here. And have you referred anybody for a surgery further? Because it was very severe, the problem was very severe.
In some patients, they were told that it's irreversible, ma'am. And few patients were. Yes, ma'am. Few patients we have referred, ma'am. And in some patients, it was so severe that it's irreversible, ma'am.
Okay. So, without the history of diabetes, the study is such.
Yes, ma'am.
So if a patient is diabetic?
We have excluded such patients, ma'am.
We have clearly excluded him.
No, if the patient is a diabetic, then the severity would be faster or slow?
It would be faster, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Means I think most of the people are diabetic and they have this habit. Because we do counseling and we see in that history. History of alcoholic, chewing tobacco are very frequently seen with history of diabetic and hypertension. So, in case you come across, might be you could want this as a sign. Thank you, your presentation was fine.
When we were doing this study, we came across a few diabetic patients who had this habit, ma'am. They had vitreal hemorrhages and all.
Did you warn them that it is a severe stage?
Yes, ma'am.
And end to your vision.
Patient, they actually asked us, ma'am, what effect does it have? We explained it to them and we told them to quit the habit, ma'am.
Quitting the habit alone will not help. You should give a psychological shock saying, in very few months you will have been losing your vision. That would treat him well and the family.
Ma'am, the irony is there was an 18-year-old boy who asked me, what if I lose my both eyes, will there be someone who will donate the two eyes to me? Like when I asked him to quit the habit.
Definitely, I will say no organ donation for such cases.
Thank you.